Hi, it's Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science here, your favorite skincare science nerd whose name starts with M and ends in Ishel. I have a PhD in chemistry and I love talking about the science behind beauty products. Today I'm teaming up with Panasonic to talk about their new skincare tools. I'm going to be talking about what they do, the science behind how they work, and how I've been incorporating them into my skincare routine. The EHSC65 Microfoam Facial Cleanser and the EHST63 Ionic Facial Cleanser and Toner. My routine is pretty straightforward and basic, but I've been really enjoying how well these tools work with my routine. They're the first home skincare products from Panasonic, which is a Japanese company, and they're inspired by the whole Japanese skincare ritual culture. These work with any skincare products, and they're designed to bump up the effectiveness and the absorption of the products into your skin. I'm going to start with an overview of each tool and the science behind how they work, and then I'm going to show you how I use them in my routine. There's a link in the description below if you want to find out more about how to incorporate them into different routines that don't have the same steps as my routine. Let's start with the Microfoam Facial Cleanser. This has a recommended retail price of $229, which is comparable with a lot of other electronic cleansing tools on the market. It's a 4-in-1 tool and it has a rotating head which has different attachments that you can put on it. It also has a heated makeup removal plate on the other end. This tool comes with a cleansing brush, but you don't have to use it as a cleansing brush, which is important because if you know how I feel about cleansing brushes, you know I think they shouldn't be used every day. And a lot of cleansing brush companies encourage you to use them every day and maybe twice a day with brushes that have really stiff bristles. In my opinion and in my experience, cleansing twice a day with a cleansing brush is only appropriate for a really small section of the population. I know a lot of people who end up over-exfoliating with cleansing brushes. If you use it too regularly, you can end up with rashes, rough skin, and stinging skin. You're taking off the top layer of your stratum corneum. This is the layer of dead skin cells on top of your skin. There's about 15 to 20 layers, and they're meant to be there to protect the rest of your skin from being exposed. I was a moderator on a skincare forum for a bit over 4 years, and it was really common to see new members come in talking about how they've been using a cleansing brush too hard and too often because the scrubbing feels really good. The problem is that the foam from the cleansing brush is really handy, and you probably need to wash your face every day with cleanser if you wear sunscreen and makeup, so it's really easy to just keep using the cleansing brush way more than you should. This device ends up getting around this problem by having a separate foaming mechanism in the middle of the tool. And the main attachment is actually this roller ball attachment. And these balls roll over your skin in a massaging motion. There's pretty much no exfoliation. And the springs stop it from pressing into your skin too hard. There's still an included brush attachment if you want to exfoliate your skin. It's got extremely soft bristles as the default brush, which I'm a big fan of. You can see how soft the bristles are, so they bend even under its own weight. I also really like that the instructions tell you how to use it and what pressure to use. They tell you to use it with such light pressure that the bristles don't bend. And they recommend that you start using once a week and stop if you feel any irritation, which I think is an important warning. There's also the pore focus brush, which has these little silicone fingers. So you're meant to use this to dislodge blackheads and the so-called sebaceous filaments, which is really just gunk in your pores. There are some extra add-on brushes that you can buy as well. There's the normal brush, which has slightly firmer bristles. I think they're the same bristles, but because they're a bit shorter, they're a little bit firmer when you press down. And there's also an exfoliation brush, which has silicone fingers in between the bristles, which are pretty much the same as the normal brush bristles. I'm really impressed by how soft these bristles are. They're a lot softer than your standard normal cleansing brushes. The best thing about this tool is that it produces a whole bunch of foam. So it gets foam out of cleansers that usually don't foam up too much to begin with. There's two heat settings on the warm makeup removing plate. There's a low setting, which is 43 degrees Celsius, and a high heat setting, which is 48 degrees Celsius. I try not to use hot water on my skin, so I was actually a bit worried that this plate might be too much for me and might cause me some irritation, but I found that it's actually not that hot. It's actually a really comfortable, soothing temperature, even on the high setting. It feels nowhere near as hot as sticking your face under the shower head. The second device is the EHST63 Ionic Cleansing and Toning Device. This is designed for cycles of 3 minutes of cleansing, moisturizing, and brightening. This is a microcurrent device that's a bit unusual because it's based on something called iontophoresis. Iontophoresis is when a really low current is passed through your skin, and studies have found that there's better skin hydration and better skin delivery of a lot of active ingredients into your skin. There have been a few studies done on iontophoresis and the delivery of different skincare ingredients, including tretinoin, which is a form of vitamin A, estrogen, vitamin E, and a few different forms of vitamin C, including ascorbic acid and magnesium ascorbyl phosphate. The clinical studies focused on treating acne scars and pigmentation. Iontophoresis is used in a lot of skincare clinics, but this is an at-home device, and I tested the current that this uses. The high current uses 90 microamps over this area. Researchers recommend an absolute maximum of 500 microamps per square centimeter, even when you're trying to get substances way deeper into your skin. At higher currents, there's also more discomfort as well, and I had no discomfort with this one. Researchers aren't 100% clear how iontophoresis works. It seems to be a combination of the electrodes repelling various ions through your skin, and the electrical current disturbing skin temporarily for better penetration. And this is highest through what are called diffusion shunts, which are places in your skin where diffusion happens better. So things like pores, hair follicles, sebaceous ducts, and sweat ducts. Skin disturbance sounds a bit scary, but with iontophoresis, it doesn't seem to last very long, and it doesn't seem to be the usual type of disturbance either. So for example, transepidermal water loss, which is when water evaporates through your skin, doesn't seem to decrease when you're using iontophoresis. So there's one electrode here, which goes on your face, and one electrode here, which you hold in your hand. So depending on which mode you're using, the current will either run from the plate into your face, through your skin, up to your arm, and then back to the device. That's in Brighten mode. When you're using the Moisturise or Massage modes, it actually runs backwards, so the current runs from this plate into your hand, along your skin, and then back out through your face. And the reason why the current runs in two different ways is because of the two main ways that iontophoresis works. Firstly, there's electrorepulsion, also known as electrophoresis. This is based on the fact that the same charge will repel the same charge. So for example, a negative charge will repel a negative charge. When this little tool is in Brighten mode, the negative plate is this plate here. That's going to turn into the cathode. The important part of vitamin C is the negatively charged part, the ascorbate ion. And so the negative cathode is going to repel it and push it deeper into your skin. The other way that iontophoresis works is through what's called electroosmosis. At normal skin pH, which is somewhere around 5, human skin actually has a slight negative charge. Things don't like just being negatively charged, so as well as your skin, there's going to be some positive ions like sodium, which is going to be sitting there neutralizing this negative charge so that overall you end up with no charge. Your skin can't move very much because it's kind of stuck in place. But these positive ions, called cations, can move. So if you have your device on your skin and this end is positive, those positively charged ions are going to go into your skin. They're also attached to water, and so it takes the water with it, and this leads to greater skin hydration. As it's taking the water, it can also take other things as well, so they kind of get caught up in the flow. So that's the reason why the direction of the current flow will change depending on the mode. There's a cleanse mode, which gets rid of anything that's remaining on your skin after cleansing. This is more like a toning step, so you'll be using this with toner and a cotton pad. This prepares your skin for better absorption of whatever ingredients you're going to put on afterwards. There's also the moisturize mode, which hydrates the skin using the mode where this end is positive. This mode uses again a cotton pad, or you can use it over a sheet mask as well. Then there's the brighten mode, which is where this plate that's on your face is negatively charged, and so you can push the negatively charged ingredients into your skin. You'll be using this with a serum or a cream that contains vitamin C. Finally, there's also the warm rhythm massage mode. There's two different modes for this. So mode number one sounds like this. I'm going to lean down to the microphone. Mode 2. Each mode has different temperatures. There's cold, warm, and room temperature. And there's also different ion levels as well. So there's low, medium, high. When you've got a circuit going, the triangular head vibrates, so you know whether or not that flow is working. The scientific studies weren't performed on this specific tool, but manufacturer studies found that it increased active ingredient delivery by 40% and it helped cleanse the skin more by 60%. I personally don't use every step every night, but I found that you can actually finish it in 15 minutes if you do all of the steps. And I think because these tools make your products more effective, it ends up being a lot faster. On different days, I'll pick and choose the steps that I use, depending on what I feel like my skin needs that particular night. Alright, so I'm going to show you what my routine looks like when I'm using these tools. I've already removed my eye makeup and my lipstick using a separate makeup remover because I don't like using my cleansing oil on those areas. I use a double cleanse at the beginning of my skincare routine. This is really popular in Asian skincare routines, like the ones used in Korean and Japanese skincare. And it's really good for people with dehydration-prone skin. Instead of using one harsh cleanser, you use two gentle cleansers that can act in slightly different ways, and so you still end up with a really thorough clean, but without all that irritation. So I start with the cleansing oil. I'm using Lee Ji Ham's Life Pure Cleansing Oil. I use it with the warm makeup removing plate. It takes about 30 seconds to warm it up. Using a really small amount of heat in your cleansing is good because while it doesn't open up your pores, it does help soften the oil inside your pores and help it flow out more easily. It's also good for helping soften your makeup, so again, it comes off more easily. It's a lot better than trying to tug at your skin. It's important that the heat you use isn't too hot, otherwise it can irritate your skin. And this temperature is quite nice. It feels a bit like I'm using maybe my hand after I've warmed it under a shower. This is on the low setting at the moment. Even on the high setting, it's really comfortable. The next step is massage cleansing, and this generally takes about a minute. I usually do this in the shower. This device is waterproof. I've got the roller massage head on. I use the soft brush about once a week with minimal pressure, and I use the silicone pore tool again once a week after I use foam. There's a bit of a misconception that all foaming cleansers are bad. A lot of low foaming cleansers are quite gentle because they contain a lot less surfactants, but there's better technology these days which makes high foam out of not very harsh ingredients. There was actually a study that found that a low foaming cleanser was actually more drying to skin than a high foaming cleanser that had lots of oils and emollients in it. I'm using Paula's Choice Hydrating Gel to Cream Cleanser. You pour the cleanser in, you need to pour water into the middle of this thing. They've got a convenient measuring tool that comes as the cap. Alright, I've got it on the soft setting, and it's recommended that you move this tool in these stripes. There's actually a lot of foam coming out. This tool pauses every 20 seconds to tell you to move to the next part. So you're meant to use it 20 seconds on this side, 20 seconds on this side, and 20 seconds on your forehead. But I find that it's actually done in way less than that. So I only really use it for about 20 seconds. You can also use this on your body, which is really great in the shower. And you can also use the massage roller head to spread cream on your face as well. For toning, I use the Ionic device. And you use it with a cotton pad. So you put the cotton pad over the triangle, and then there's this ring which goes on top. You soak it with whatever toner you want. I'm using Claire's Supple Preparation Unscented Toner, which I'm almost out of. It's cleanse mode. I'm using medium iron, and I'm going for room temperature. So it makes a pulsing sound. And this step gets rid of any leftover dirt on your skin. This step also hydrates your skin. If your skin's well hydrated, then it tends to absorb your skincare products much more efficiently. And you can actually see that I've gotten some dirt out. Gross. The next step is sheet masking. A lot of people use the sheet mask at the end of their routine, but I like using it at this stage to just hydrate my skin a bit more. I'm using the Real Barrier Aqua Soothing Ampoule Mask. My biggest issue with sheet masks is that I don't like sitting around waiting for it to be done. So I really like how this tool speeds up how quickly the sheet mask works. So this time I'm using the Moisturise mode. Again, I'm using medium, and I'm going to be using room temperature. So the mask says 10 to 20 minutes, but after about 3 minutes using the tool, I'm done with it. So the next step is brightening. I currently have a nasty pimple here, so what I'm doing is I'm putting a bit of Resist Advanced Pore Refining Treatment, which is 4% BHA from Paula's Choice, on that little pimple, which is threatening to turn into a big pimple. Die. Die. And I'm going to be using Skin Diva 20% Vitamin C plus E plus Ferulic Serum. Vitamin C is a really good skincare ingredient because it acts to fade pigment and it's a really good antioxidant as well, which means it quenches the free radicals in your skin, which can cause lots of skin damage. I've got another video which is about antioxidants, which I've linked in the description. I have a lot of problems with pigment because I'm Asian, and Asians are really good at producing pigment, as you can tell from my amazing hair. The problem with vitamin C is that it's really bad at getting through your skin, and so pushing it through iontophoresis is a really good way of getting it into your skin deeper. If your serum's all absorbed, then you'll find that the TEWL doesn't glide over your skin as smoothly, and the current can drop a bit. So I like to use a thermal water, which is from Aven, to re-wet my skin if that happens. So now I'm up to my final two steps, which are eye cream and moisturizer. The eye cream I'm using is one from Jurlique. It's the Herbal Recovery Signature Eye Cream. With my eye creams, I'm not really looking for actives. I just spread whatever active serum I have up to the eye region. And I'm selecting the massage mode, and I'm using it on warm temperature. So I'm doing this rolling motion so that I don't tug at the delicate skin around my eyes. Now the final step is moisturizing. So again, I'm going to be using massage mode. Today I'm using Alpha H Essential Hydration Cream, and the thing I like most about this is that it has a pump top. So I pump a bit out onto the top. I add some Zellens Power D. I find that this is really nice for calming down sensitive skin. Now I'm using the first massage mode on warm temperature, and I'm going to press it in. It's a really nice soothing massage. And I'm done. If you want a bit more info on how you can use it in your routine, if you have steps that aren't in my routine, you can click on the link and you'll see what Panasonic's recommendations are. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked it, please click the thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much to Panasonic for collaborating with me on this project. For more skincare tips, you can check me out on Lab Muffin Beauty Science on Instagram, and you can check out my blog if you're interested in learning more about the science behind beauty products. See you next time.